Hello friends, today we will see how to extend a subset to a basis of a vector space. So before going to see how to extend, we have to see what is basis, and before to that, what is vector space. So first we will see vector space. So vector space is nothing but a set of vectors that is denoted as capital V. So you can write it as V1, V2 and so on, Vn. So if this set obeys 8 properties, from that 8 properties we have first 4 vector addition and last 4 is scalar multiplication. Now if those properties will be satisfied by V, then that set V is called vector space. Now a subset of vector space is said to be basis only when it has to satisfy 2 properties. So what are they? We will see. So we will see next is subset. So subset, if the subset is linearly independent, and if I write this subset as S or denote this subset as S, second property it should satisfy what? S spans V. Then this is called what? This is called basis. So now we will see what is linear independent. So if here you will see this one, linear independent. If S is having set U1, U2 and UN vectors, if we write the linear combination of these vectors, this alpha 1 U1 plus alpha 2 U2 plus and so on plus alpha N UN equal to 0 for all alpha I equal to 0, I equal to 1, 2, N. Then we call that these vectors U1, U2, UN are linearly independent. Now the second property is what? S spans V means what? These vectors U1, U2, UN, this will generate the vector space V. So how we will see? So if a vector is W, is any arbitrary vector you can take W, that is in V vector space, and if we can express W in terms of this V1, U2, UN vectors, then we say that S spans V and W is arbitrary. That means using U1, U2, UN, we can what? Generate all the vectors of this vector space. Then that will be called basis. Now here we will see that any subset of V can be extended to basis of that vector space. That we have to see. Now we will consider the problem, and the problem is that extend S is the set 1 1 1 1 comma 3 3 4 5. Now we have 2 vectors and we have to extend this basis to a basis of R4, real line R4. So how to do that? So here one point we have to remember, that basis is not unique. That means for a vector space there are many bases, it is not unique, means there will be no one basis, we can have 2 or more bases. So how to get the basis, that we have to see. So S is having what? 2 vectors, but will be in R4, so there should be 4 vectors to satisfy the basis. Now what are the 4 vectors, that we have to see, and how to get, so that this vector will be a basis. So we'll see how to do. So first we will write this in matrix form. So first vector will be 1, 1, 1, 1. Second will be 3, 3, 4, 5. So now what we will do, we have to convert into row echelon form. So in row echelon form, what we have to do, we have to operate row transformation and convert this matrix to upper triangular matrix. So what we will do here, so first what to do, this is a pivot element, first pivot element. Pivot element means the first leading non-zero element of the row is pivot element. So first pivot element is 1, so below to that we have to make the entry 0. So we have to make this entry 0. So how to do, we have to change R2 as R2 minus 3R1. If we do that, then what will happen, first row will be same. So 1, 1, 1, 1, second row will be 0, 0, then this will be 1, this will be 2. So we got this one, and this will be in the what? Echelon form, row echelon form. Now here, how to decide what are the two next vectors so that the new S set will become the basis of R4. Means those four vectors will satisfy the linear independent property and spans R4. So what to do here, we have to observe keenly. We have to see that after getting the final row echelon form, we have to see what are the leading non-zero entries or what are the pivot elements. So here the first row, first element is pivot, and the second row, third entry is the pivot row. So this is third place, this is first place. So which place, as we have four places, and from four places, first place is 1 and third, means first place is a pivot element and third place is also pivot element. So what are the left pivot elements? The left pivot elements will be in position 2 and position 4. So what we can write for those two vectors? So as we know, position second place will be vacant. So for that we can write this, construct this vector 0, 1, 0, 0. So in this way we can construct another vector, and the fourth one will be in fourth pivot element will be vacant. So for that fourth entry we can take 1 and other entry will be 0. So that way we can construct the fourth vector. Now we got four vectors. Now what are the vectors will form basis? Now the new, that is S tilde, we can write S tilde is the basis. So basis will be 1, 1, 1, 1 is the first row, means first vector, then 0, 0, 1, 2, and another two vectors are 0, 1, 0, 0, and 0, 0, 0, 1. So these four vectors will form a basis of R4. So as I told, basis is not unique, but in this way we can construct a basis. Other basis will also satisfy the property, but we may not extend S in that way. So in this way we can extend the basis.